In this class, we'll start with another two methods of applied control of insect pest. Those are cultural method and the chemical method. So, what are these cultural method and the chemical methods? What are the different steps are taken in this method to control the insect pest population? First one, that is cultural method. What are these cultural method? The name itself tell a use of some of the methods in a field by a farmers to reduce the population of the insect pest without involving any major methods or without the using of any equipments. How these insect will be controlled? By using some of the cultural techniques that will be studied under this cultural method. So this cultural method, the regular farm operations performed by cultivators in order to reduce the population of insect pests, to minimize the level of economic injury, is called cultural control. So in this cultural control, the farmers, they will use some of the regular farm operations. Through these operation, they will reduce the population of insect pest. That is called as a cultural control. Or the control of insect pest through adoption of some of the ordinary farm practices in a appropriate time so that they can control these insects or they can eliminate these insects from the fields. So in this cultural method, they will adopt some of the ordinary farm practices. Through this practice, they will eradicate or eliminate or the reduce the population of the insects. That is called as the cultural control. And this cultural control, it is the most cheapest form of the insect control measure. So in this cultural method, without the expenditure of any money, we can control or eradicate the population of the insects by applying or by adopting some of the ordinary farm practices. So what are these methods or applications used in this cultural method? How these insects will be controlled? This is the cheapest of all the control measures, as it requires only the adjustment of ploughing, sowing, irrigation and harvesting time, which is being done in the normal course of farming. So in this culture method, only by adjusting the time of the ploughing, sowing, irrigation and the harvesting time, we can control the population of the insects. As if we change these methods of farming in time, we can control the insect growth and we can completely eradicate these insects from the field. So these are some of the methods they adopt during the farming. So these ploughing, sowing, irrigation and the harvesting methods will be adjusted so that growth of the insects will be reduced. Following are some of such practices. So in this cultural method, we use some of the methods to reduce the population. Those are by clean cultivation, by rotating the crops, or by crop rotation, by tilling or cultivating the soil, use of resistant varieties, and by using the clean seeds, and by varying the sowing and harvesting time. By doing the mixed cropping, we can control the population of the insects. So in this cultural method, what are the different practices or ordinary farm practices will be done in order to reduce the population of these insects? First one, that is clean cultivation. So during the cultivation, we should follow some of the rules. So while cultivating, the field should be clean. So the regular removal of all weeds and residues of crop is an important factor in reducing the pest population. Since insect pests of crops feed on the weeds in the absence of host plants. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತಾ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಈ ಒಂದು ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಇವಾಗ ಒಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸನ್ನು ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ದ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ವೀಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೆಸಿಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ reduce the population of the insects, as these insects feed on the weeds that are present in a crops in the absence of the host plant. So before growing the crops, we have to clean the fields. So it is one of the cultural method of insect control. Then second one, that is crop rotation and trap crops. So the crop rotation, it is nothing but a rotation of the crop in a field. Rotation of crops has proved to be most effective control measure against those pests which are monophagous and restricted feeders, slow breeder and having longer duration of feeding phase. ಸೊ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ರೊಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಎದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಒಂದೊಂದಿಷ್ಟು ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಮೋನೋಫೆಗಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಟೋಟಲಿ ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಮೋನೋಫೆಗಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫೀಡರ್, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಚೇಂಜ್ ದ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್. ಈ ಸಲ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಗೋಧಿ ಬೆಳೆದಿರಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಜೋಳ ಬೆಳೆಯೋದು. ಈ ಥರ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಆ ಒಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸನ್ನು ರೊಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು. ಈ ಫಸ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಗೋಧಿ ಬೆಳೆದಿರಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರುವಂಥ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಎನ್ ಮೋನೋಫ್ಯಾಗಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದೀಸ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಅಗೇನ್ ಸೋ ದೀಸ್ ವೀಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್, again the crop yield will be disrupted. So in order to reduce the population of these insect pest on these wheat, so we have to rotate the crop in a field. So the rotation of crops has proved to be most effective control measure against these pests which are monophagous or restricted feeders, slow breeder and having longer duration of feeding phase. So these monophagous and the restricted feeders, they are slow breeders. Their breeding time is slow and have a longer duration of the feeding phase. So these factor will affect the crop. So in order to reduce these pests from the crop field, we have to rotate the crops which we grow in a field. Around the major crop in the field, some early growing Other preferred crop is sown in strips, which is termed as a strap crop or a trap crop. This is the crop rotation. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇರೆ ಫೀಲ್ಡನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಗೋಧಿ ಬೆಳೆದಿರಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಏನೋ ಬೇರೆ ಕ್ರಾಪನ್ನು ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಅಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು. ಒಂದು ಸೀಸನಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಬೆಳೆದಿರಿ ಅಂದರೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸೀಸನಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪನ್ನ ಬೆಳೆದು. ಸೊ ಥ್ರೂ ದೀಸ್ ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಬೈ ರೊಟೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಆರ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್. ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಫಿಂಗ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಲೀಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಇನ್ಫೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ವೈಟ್ ಗ್ರಬ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೋಸ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಬೈ ಟಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್, ಈ ಒಂದು ಗಳೆ ಹೊಡೆಯೋದಂತಾರಲ್ಲ, ಇದರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಂತಂದರೆ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ವಾ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ರಬ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಲಾರ್ವಾ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಗ್ರಬ್ಸ್ ವೈಲ್ ಟಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್. ಸೊ ಥ್ರೂ ದೀಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಇನ್ಫೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ವೈಟ್ ಗ್ರಬ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ವೈಟ್ ಗ್ರಬ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್. ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಟಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಇನ್ಫೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರಬ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೋಸ್ ಟು ದ ಸನ್ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಿಲ್ಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್, ಟಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಟಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಥವಾ ಕನ್ನಡದ ಗಳೆ ಹೊಡೆಯೋದಂತಾರೆ, ಎದಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಸಾಯಿಲಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ವಾ ಆಫ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಥ್ರೂ ದೀಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ these larva present in the soil will be exposed to sun and they will be destructed. This is one of the cultural method, that is tilling or cultivating of soil. Then fourth method, that is use of resistant varieties. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು resistant varieties ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಒಂದೊಂದಿಷ್ಟು crops ಇರ್ತವೆ, ಆ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ದೇ ಆರ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಎನಿ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೆಸ್. ಸೊ ಆ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾದಂಥ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವೆರೈಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇನ್ಫೆಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮಿನಿಮಲ್ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. Certain resistant varieties of crops are least infected by particular pest in comparison to other varieties of crops by the same pest. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವೆರೈಟಿ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಬೆಳೆಯೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಫೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಬೇರೆ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸನ್ನು ಯೂಶುವಲ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸನ್ನು ಬೆಳೆದಾಗ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ರೀತಿಯಿಂದನೂ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟು ಹಾಳು ಮಾಡೋ ಚಾನ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ವೆರಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವೆರೈಟೀಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಫೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವೆರೈಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ ಕಾಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದೀಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್. Nowadays, insect-resistant plant varieties are being produced by hybridization, grafting and pure line selection by farmers. So, even the resistant varieties, present day, they are more popular. So, these resistant variety crops will be produced by the hybridization. So, they will be crossed with some of the crops and they will be produced through this hybridization process. Through the grafting, the two different plant will be fused by the process of grafting. Through this process we can produce these resistant varieties. And the pure line selection, this is the another method used by the farmers for the production of these resistant varieties. As these resistant varieties, they are least infective to the insect pest. So through the use of these resistant varieties, we can reduce the cause of the insect, or we can reduce the population of the insect pest. The fifth method, that is use of clean seed. Seeds also play important role in carrying the pests from one crop to the next. So only tested and certified seeds should be used for growing new crops. Thus, before sowing, seed should be fumigated by the methyl bromide phosphine or carbon bisulfide. So ಏನಾಗುತ್ತಾ ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಮೆಥಡಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಏನಂತಂದರೆ, ಥ್ರೂ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಸೀಡ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್, ಆರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಈ ಒಂದು ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಸೀಡ್ ಏನಂತಂದರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತಾ ಇವಾಗ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪ್ನ ಬೆಳೆದಿದ್ದಾರ, ಬೆಳೆದಿರುವಂಥ ಕ್ರಾಪಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಈಲ್ಡ್ ಬಂದೈತಿ. ಆ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪಲ್ಲಿ ಈಲ್ಡ್ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಬಂದೈತಿ ಅಂತ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಬೇರೆಯೊಬ್ಬರು ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಾರೆ, ಸೀಡ್ಸನ್ನು ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ತಾವು ತಮ್ಮ ಫೀಲ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಳೀತಾರೆ. ಆ ಬೆಳಿಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ದೇ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಸೊ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ಮೇ ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೆಸ್. ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪಿಂದ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೀವಿ, ಸೀಡ್ಸನ್ನು ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೀವಿ. ಆ ಸೀಡ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಾನೆ, ದೇ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೆಸ್. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ತೊಗೊಂಡೋಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಫೀಲ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ನಾವು ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಅಗೇನ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಗ್ರೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್. ಓನ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗ್ರೋ ದ ಸರ್ಟಿಫೈಡ್ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್. ಇಫ್ ದ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಎನಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್, ದೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗ್ರೋ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್, ಆರ್ ದೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೋ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ದ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ before sowing the seeds in our field, we have to fumigate these, we have to fumigate these seeds with the some of the chemicals like methyl bromide phosphine or carbon bisulfate. Through fumigation of these chemicals to seeds, then we can sow these seeds in our field. So use of clean seed is necessary in the cultural method, as it will reduce the growth of these insect pests, or we can control the growth of these insect pests by using the clean seed. Sixth method, that is variation in sowing and harvesting time. A careful adjustment in the sowing period of crop influences the attack of insect pests. Most of the insect pests lay maximum number of eggs during confined phases if host plants are available. So, ಏನು through the change in a sowing and harvesting time, we can control the life cycle of some of the insect pest. As these insects, they will have their life cycle. They are adjusted to the some of the seasons. So through changing these sowing and harvesting time, we can control the attack of these insect pests on our crop. So by adjusting these sowing and harvesting time, we can eradicate these insect pests. As these insect pests, they lay maximum number of eggs during some of the confined phases or confined seasons. So if the host plant is available in that season, these insect growth will be more as they feed on this host plant. So if we change the sowing and harvesting time, then the life cycle of these insect pests will be disrupted as the host plant is not available in the confined area or a confined field. So through the changing of the sowing and harvesting time, we can disrupt the life cycle of the insect pest and we can protect our crops. Then another method, that is mixed cropping. By applying the mixed cropping scheme in the field, one can reduce the intensity of pest infestation by creating hindrance in the normal spread of pest. If certain crops are sown mixed with others, the insect pest associated with the host crop takes comparatively much time to reach the other host plant due to presence of the non-host plant in between because of the distance. ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಒಂದೇ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸನ್ನು ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡೋದು. ದಟ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೇನಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕ್ರಾಪಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕ್ರಾಪಿಂಗಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ವೆಜಿಟೇಬಲ್ಸ್ನ ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕ್ರಾಪಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ವೈಲ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕ್ರಾಪಿಂಗ್, we can reduce the intensity of the pest infestation. Because ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪು ಇವೇನು ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪಿನ ಮೇಲೆ ಹಾಳು ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತಾವೆ. ಆ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಹಾಳು ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತಾವೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಫುಡ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್. If we do these mixed cropping, it will be inconvenient for these insect pest to jump from one crop to another as the non-host plant present in between the host plants. ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಒಂದ್ರೋ ಏನೋ ಬೆಳೆದಿರಿ, ಅದ್ರ ಪಕ್ಕ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಬೇರೆ ಬೆಳೆದಿರ್ತೀರಿ. ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪಿಗೆ ಜಂಪ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ನಡುವರ್ಕ್ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಬೇರೆ ನಾನ್ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕ್ರಾಪಿಂಗಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕನ್ವೀನಿಯಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ದ ಕ್ರಾಪ್. ಸೊ ಥ್ರೋ ದೀಸ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕ್ರಾಪಿಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ or it will reduce the pest infestation in these mixed cropping. In these mixed cropping, a certain crops will be sown mixed with the others. The insect pest associated with the host crop takes comparatively much time to reach the other host plant as the non-host plant is present in between the two host plant. So it will be inconvenient for these insect pests to jump from one host plant to another host plant. So due to this distance between the host plant, the pest infestation will be reduced and we can control the cause of these insect pest in these crop field by implementing the mixed cropping. So these are the methods which we use in the cultural method of insect pest. Those are clean cultivation, crop rotation and trap crops, tilling or cultivating of soil, use of resistant varieties, use of clean seed, variation in sowing and harvesting time, and the mixed cropping. So this is about the cultural method of insect control. Then the fourth method in the applied control, that is chemical control. What are these chemical control? Chemical control is nothing but a use of chemicals in order to kill the pests. That is called as a chemical control. Or in other words, any method to eradicate or limit the growth of pathogen or a pest which cause damage to plants. So in this chemical control, we use some of the methods to eradicate or limit the growth of some of the pests which cause damage to the plants. Through using some of the chemicals or methods, we can eradicate these insect pests from the crop field. So through using the chemicals, we kill the pests. So the chemical control method includes the use of insecticides. So insecticides, you guys already know, insecticide are nothing but a pesticides. So these insecticides will be prepared from some of the chemicals. So these chemicals will damage the insects by making its host suppressed, or it will totally disrupt the metabolism of the insects and it will kill the insects. So these in these chemical control, we use insecticides. These insecticide will make the host unstable and make, or it will kill the pests or insects. Then the fumigants. What are these fumigants? These are nothing but the pesticides. These fumigants, these are pesticides which form a gas, and these are toxic to insect pests. So these fumigants will be in the form of the gaseous states at a required temperature, and they will be present in a sufficient concentration, and it will be lethal to some of the pests. If fumigants say no, they will be in the form of the gaseous states, and they will be fumigated to the crops to kill the insect population. Then comes the attractants. What are these attractants? These attractants are nothing but a pheromones. The pheromones will be used in these chemical control. So these pheromones, it will always attract some of the insects. So in a particular field, we use some of the pheromones. So these pheromones will attract the insects, and then it will, through using these attractants, we can reduce the use of these insecticide. So as we know, these insecticides or the pesticides will be costlier. So by using these pheromones or attractants, we can reduce the use of insecticide. These insecticide have some of the problems. If we use or if we spray more insecticide in a crop, it may be lethal to organisms. So by using these attractants, we can reduce the use of insecticides. These attractants will be mainly formed from the pheromones. So these attractant will trap the insects. Then comes the repellents. these repellents will be used in a chemical control. These repellents, they will kill the insects or they will prevent or destroy the insect pests, or they will repel the insects from causing damage to the plants. So these repellents will be used in a chemical control. Then antifeedants. So some of the antifeedants will be used in a chemical control. These antifeedants are nothing but these are organic compound. They are secreted or synthesized by the plants. As these plants will be inhibited by or they will be attacked by some of the insects or grazing animals. So in order to avoid these damage from the insects or grazing animals, some of the plants will synthesize these antifeedants or organic compounds. So these antifeedants are considered as a secondary metabolites. So already you know these secondary metabolites will be synthesized by the plants in order to prevent themselves from the predators like insects or animals. Then synergists. So even the synergists, you know, antandre, these are some of the chemical compound. They will be used along with the pesticides for a more effective way. So even the synergists avaglu edru jothe use martarandre, they will be mixed along with the pesticides to kill the insect population. So these are some of the chemical control methods used in this chemical control. So yavyav chemical control use martara antane, by using the insecticides, fumigants, attractants, repellents, antifeedants, synergists, etc. Ili insecticides are nothing but chemicals or pesticides used in order to kill the insect pest. Then fumigants are nothing but pesticides which are in the form of the gaseous or gaseous states. Then attractants, these attractants are nothing but use of pheromones. These pheromones will attract the insects and we can reduce the population through these. Using these attractants, we can reduce the use of insecticide. Then comes the repellents. Repellents are nothing but they will repel the insects. Then antifeedants, these are the chemical organic compounds synthesized by the plants. Then synergists, these are used along with the pesticides in order to kill the insects. First one, that is insecticide. So in these chemical control, there are some of the methods. Through these method, we can completely eradicate the insects from the crop field. Those are insecticide. First one is insecticide, the substance which kill the insects due to their properties of having chemical actions are termed as insecticide. With the discovery of insecticidal spectrum of DDT in 1935. So for the first time, the chemical that is used to kill the insects, that is DDT. So this is the first spectrum in a insecticide, that is DDT. The real concept of insecticide and insect control was revolutionized. As a result, insecticide has become the boon of applied entomology. So these insecticide, after the discovery of the insecticide DDT, it is again improved or revolutionized. So as a result, these insecticide has become the boon of applied entomology. So these insecticides are used in order to eradicate the insects. So these insecticide has become the boon to the applied entomology. Here entomology is nothing but a insect study of insects, that is called as a entomology. So this is the about the insecticide. These insecticide are nothing but a substances which kill the insects due to their properties of having chemical actions. These insecticide have a chemical actions, due to this they will kill the insecticides. Then qualities of insecticide. If we use some of the insecticide in a crop field, what are the qualities the insecticide should have? Should be very potent against insect pests even at a lower dose. So if we use the insecticide, it should be very potent against the insect pest, even though we have a lower dose of the insecticide. So if we spray the lower dose of the insecticide, it should show a very effective action against this insect pest. So these insecticides should be very potent against insect pests even at a lower doses. Should not endanger human health, domestic animals and plants. So if we are spraying some of the insecticide to the crop, one should know it does not harm any humankind or any animal or any plant. So these insecticide should not endanger human health, domestic animals and plants. Third point, should break down into harmless compounds after some time when used. So if we are spraying these insecticide on a crop, these insecticide should break into the harmless compound. So even the insecticide spray maadidaga enuntane adenagbeku antane harmless compound agi enuntane break down aabeku. So yavade reetiyadanta insecticide yavade organisms ge harm aaglardange enandre they have to break down into a harmless compounds. Fourth point, should not leave objectionable residues where they are applied. So these insecticides, after spraying to some of the crops, they should not leave any objectionable residues or harmful residues should not be leave from these insecticide after spraying or applying. Then fifth point, should be spread uniformly, having better adhesiveness. These insecticides should be spread uniformly in a crop, and these insecticides should have some of the adhesiveness, so that we can control these insect pest. If we add these insecticide on the plant, they have to present on the crops for some time, or they should show some of the adhesiveness and uniform spreading in a crop field. Sixth point, should be easy in operation. The insecticide should have some of the easy to operate by any people. So they should show a property that they should be easy in operation and should be cheap to manufacture. Next, enu antandre ivaga as a customer, if we are going to select some of the insecticide, we think some these insecticide should have these all our properties and it should be available in a cheap price. So these are some of the feature every buyer wants. So these insecticides should be cheap to manufacture and should be easily available in the market. Then 9th point, should have better compatibility with other material. So these insecticide should show a better compatibility with the other materials. So these are some of the qualities of the insecticide. Then formulations of insecticide. For easy application, insecticides are formulated in various ways like dust, granules, solution, wettables, powder, emulsifiable concentrates, concentrate liquid, fumigants, aerosols, mists or mixed formulation. So these insecticides will be available in different form for various purposes. So these insecticides are formulated in various ways for a application in a crop field. So these insecticides will be available in a dust, granules, solutions or wettables, powders, etc. Then insecticides available for common use are rarely in pure form. So they are always marked in a lower concentration, which may be further diluted at the time of application as per need. So these insecticides will do not found in a pure form. So these insecticides will be always be mixed with some other chemicals and they will be diluted while the time of application. Then the classification based on the mode of entry. So these insecticides will be classified based on the mode of entry in a organisms. So those are stomach poison, contact poison and systemic poison and the fumigants. Here in the stomach poison, these insecticides will be applied with some of the food material. So when the insects ingest this food, they will automatically cause the stomach poison. So these insecticides will be classified based on the mode of entry. When the insecticides mixed with the food, these insecticides, they will ultimately cause poison in the stomach. Then contact poison. In the contact poison, the toxic chemical which kills the insects by the simple contact or a touch. So if the insects, they touch the, or when they come contact with the insecticide or a toxic chemical, they will die. So in a single touch or a simple contact, these insects will be killed. That is a contact poison. Then systematic or a systemic poison. So in these systemic, insecticide is applied to the root, stem, leaves and seeds of the plant. Then it will be absorbed and reach the different parts of the plants. As the insect feed on the these treated plant, their mechanism changes and they will disrupt the gut of the insects. So in this systemic poison, the insecticide will be applied to the different parts of the plants. When the insect absorb these toxic or insecticide, they will disrupt the insect metabolism. So it will make the stomach poison and kill the insects. So this is a mode of entry through the systemic poison. Then fumigants. Fumigants are applied as a vapor and they will affect the respiratory stem in the insects and it will cause the death in insects. So in this way, through different application of insecticide, they will enter into the gut or a body of the insects and totally disrupt the insecticide. So in this way, through the entry of the insecticide in a stomach, it will cause death of the insects. If the insects come in contact with the toxic chemical, they will die. Then through applying the insecticide to different parts of the plants, when these plants will be fed by the insects, their gut system will be disrupted or it will cause poison to the stomach and the ultimately leads to the death of insects. By applying the fumigants or insecticide in a vapor form, they will disrupt the respiratory system of the insects and cause death in the insects. So these are the classification based on the mode of entry. Second one, that is insect attractants. Already I have said, in these chemical control we use some of the attractants. These attractants are nothing but pheromones. So these pheromones, it will attract the insects and trap these insects. Attractants are chemical substances which cause orientation of insects towards the source of attractant. So these attractant, it will make orientation of the insects and it will make the insects to come towards the attractant. So through these attractant we can trap the insects. Some very important synthetic attractants are trimmed lure, Q-lure and methyl eugenol. These are the three synthetic attractants are oftenly used in a field as a attractants. These chemicals, it will attract the insects and it will give a orientation to the insects and they will follow these attractants and will be trapped. Attractants are used as a bait in the field to attract insects at particular place where they can be killed easily by applying or spraying suitable insecticide. So this is the sheet where they applied the attractants. To these attractants, these insects come and bind. So in this way, we can kill by spraying some of the chemicals. So these attractants, it will totally attract all the insects. Then by spraying the chemical, we can kill the population of the insects. The third one, that is insect repellent. Substance which may not be active poison or mild poisons prevent plants or animal by making the food or living conditions of the insect unattractive or defense to them are called as the repellent. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಈವನ್ ದ ರಿಪೆಲೆಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಾನ್ಸು, ಇದೇನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಟೋಟಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟಿಗೆ ಏನಾದರೂ ಸ್ಪ್ರೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಏನಂತಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅನ್ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟು ದ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಇವಾಗ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಅದ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನೋಡ್ತಾವೆ. ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಪ್ರೇ ದೀಸ್ ರಿಪೆಲೆಂಟ್ ಟು ದ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ಸ್, ದೀಸ್ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅನ್ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟು ದ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಥ್ರೂ ದೀಸ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ದ insect population, or we can totally avoid these insect from the plants. So these insect repellents are oftenly used in a field. So these insect repellent, it will make plants unattractive to the insects. So this is about the insect repellent. Up to now we studied about the chemical control. So chemical control are nothing but a chemicals used in order to kill the insect in a field, that is called as a chemical control. In this chemical control, we use some of the insecticide, fumigants, attractants, repellent, antifeedants and synergies to kill the insect pest or to avoid the insects from attacking to the crop field. So those are insecticides, qualities of insecticide we study, then formulations of these insecticides and the classification based on a mode of entry, then insect attractants and the insect repellent. So this is about the chemical control in a applied control of pest. So totally we studied in these applied control, those are mechanical control, physical control, cultural control and the chemical control. These are the four methods we use in these, or these four methods are oftenly used in a applied control of insect pest. In the next class, we will start with the integrated pest management.